Live from the Doss House in Sydney. Woohoo! Let me hear you give it up for the Doss House in Sydney, everybody. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Now, on behalf of the Lands End Club Board, I'd like to welcome all of our members here tonight, and indeed their friends and family, and of course all of the Irish community to whom we've extended a very kind invitation to tonight. Now, for over 30 years, the Lands End Club has been the premier Irish business network in Australia. Each and every year, we hold the largest Lands End Club, we hold the largest St. Patrick's Day luncheon in the world. And this year, under very trying circumstances, was no different. 7 months on, we've invited you all back again to a much smaller venue, but indeed still allowing so many people to tune in to hear from two of the people who made that luncheon a huge success. We're honored and privileged to have His Excellency, the Irish Ambassador to Australia, Brendan O'Quailey. How are you, Brendan? One of my best friends. I've just had a mind blank. Who's going to be joining us from Canberra in a Q&A with Katie O'Connell. And following on from that, our good friend Peter Byrne is going to be here right in the Doss House playing live, not just some of the Neil Diamond classics, but he's always going to play...
A bit of Irish as well.
Yeah, a bit of Irish.
A bit of Irish as well.
How about that? How excited does Peter sound to be here? Hey. Now, before I throw over to Katie, it would be remiss of me not to introduce you to Kira Dorn. Kira is the general manager and the licensee for the Doss House, and she's going to join us on camera here, if we can squeeze ourselves across. Hello, Kira, how are you? Are you well?
I'm great, thank you, Philip.
Now, I want you to tell us, Kira, what's been going on with the Doss House through COVID and the restrictions?
Well, obviously, like many businesses, we had to close our doors for a couple of months. So that was, we had to evolve and see what we could do. But we're out the other end.
That's fantastic.
And as of this weekend, I think lots of exciting things are happening, especially in the Rocks.
That's right. We're seeing that in the news all the time. So restrictions are lifting, more Aussies, more tourists coming down.
Absolutely. So from tomorrow, we have a new outdoor area.
Fantastic.
Opening up the dockyard. So we can fit lots more people in, which is great because we've been obviously had a tiny capacity for so long. We'll see a lot more live music coming back, so I feel like we're coming out the other end.
Now, what do you think you guys are known for best? Is it the perfect pints of Guinness? Is it the whiskey? Is it the gin? Is it the charcuterie boards that every eastern suburbs princess loves?
I think it's a bit of everything, but but honestly, I think everyone that comes down here loves a pint of Guinness. And that's what we're judged on most. And I think that getting that feedback to make sure that we get the best pint of Guinness is very important.
It is. I can tell you right now, after having had...
Philip has sampled one, I've just sampled.
Yeah, just to make sure it was all on temperature. Yeah. So if we look like we've got people... Katie, can you see us?
I can see you.
I can see you waving there. Brendan, my very good friend Brendan, whose name I'm never going to forget again. Brendan, I can see you waving. Right, well, that's enough from us in the Doss House. We'll be back to you shortly. In the meantime, sit back, relax, forget about Trump, forget about COVID, forget about Biden, and forget about Daryl Maguire. Listen to the ambassador.
All right.
Jesus Christ, I'm so...
Oh, on sound.
Now, I have to caveat that and say there may be one or two COVID questions thrown in there, but we'll try and limit them as much as we can. Thank you so much, Brendan, for being here. Thanks for coming, and we're so delighted to have you. So, it's great to have you, and we'd love to know how you've been spending this lockdown period. Have you been going as insane as the rest of us?
Yeah, well, I suppose we're very lucky, if I can use a word like that in terms of what we're facing in Ireland and across Australia. But Canberra has been had very little impact here. So life is comparatively normal. We've been able to go. We've been able to maintain some of our official activities. One I want to mention in particular in a moment. But overall, I suppose we're like everybody else. We're very concerned. Because we have responsibilities and working with the Irish community right across Australia. And then we have our own personal concerns for our families back home in Ireland, families elsewhere. But look, this is a great night, and I want to thank the Lands End Club. It always is a great opportunity for crack. I mean, the last big event I attended before everything closed down was, of course, the lunch on the 13th of March, usual fantastic event. So it's great to have this. This is a great way of lifting the spirits. And I think, to be serious again for a moment, I suppose a lot of people are feeling this very heavy if I can use the phrase, mental health issues are common. So this is a great opportunity just to kind of say, look, you know, we are facing tough times. We do all have to pull together, but we can have a bit of fun still. And that's the great message from tonight. And that's what I want to be part of. So thanks for that, Katie.
Yeah, of course. And that's exactly what we wanted to do, is just bring the community together and just, you know, still have an event and still have something to look forward to, and just to be able to kind of reconnect and have a bit of fun. So really appreciate you being here. And so what have you been missing during COVID that you want to be back, that you want to get back to? Is there anything that you've been missing terribly in the lockdown period?
Well, I suppose like everybody, the very limited travel, I will be traveling next week, as happened in South Australia, but limited travel. Normally I'm doing an awful lot of travel, and I suppose one of the biggest victims, if I can do it on a very strong personal level, is we couldn't travel home over the summer for various reasons. And we became, myself and Carmel, my wife, became grandparents for the first time in June.
Oh, congratulations.
10th. We've seen him on WhatsApp, and we listened to him gurgling, and we talked to him, and I sing lullabies to him in Irish, but we haven't been able to see him. So no, but like other people have had it much tougher. So, but I suppose funny enough, traveling, which when you're doing it is a pain, but when you're not doing it, you kind of miss it because there's a whole buzz about it. There's the excitement of going to various places, meeting the Irish community around Australia. And it's great fun. I love my job and I love traveling. Well, I don't love traveling. I love when I get there.
yeah.
I don't love traveling, but listen, that's one of the things. But one of the things I want to mention is about 2 weeks ago, we had a gala event, we call it, halfway to St. Patrick's Day. And we had it out in a place called Pielago, which is vineyard just on the edge of the city here beside the airport. And we had it themed. We had an Irish menu. We had some Irish ingredients. We had traditional Irish music. We had a harpist. We had a promotion of various, Ireland is a tourist destination, industry and all the rest. So we're still getting some work done on that level. But, you know, it is a pity that so much of what we would normally be doing, what Lansdowne we'd be doing, you would be doing, is not possible. But look, we're Irish, so we've come through tough times, and we'll.
Yeah, and that's it. And people are getting a bit creative, aren't they? Because they have to think of outside the box to stay connected, and you know, to still have those relationships and that excitement in their life. So, I know, for example, in my family, we're doing a lot of family quizzes. So we'll like do a Zoom call and do a family quiz. It's just been a lot of fun. But is there anything that you've been doing that's helping you to stay connected to your family? You mentioned obviously your WhatsApp calls, but is there anything you're kind of doing to try and, you know, keep those connections going so that you feel like you still have a good community around you?
Yeah, I suppose we do. And actually, to go off, absolutely. And as I say, we have regular, we've got our own, they're all adult children, as indeed, obviously, one of them has become a mother, but and with other families. So just regular contact. Arguably, we're in more contact now because we use WhatsApp yeah. Rather than emails and rather than messages and rather than quick phone calls. I suppose we've all know how precious the time is with our families and our friends, and miss them. But just the whole virtual world we've gone into, like with some great concerts, fundraising concerts that Lansdowne supported. We had Flachéol na hÉireann in Mullingar virtually, and I think Australia was very well represented. Sydney, Brisbane, Perth, Melbourne and Canberra all had slots on the TG Carr program. So, you know, we're using the time very well for our culture and keeping in contact. And it's made the world smaller, if it's kind of darker, if I can put it that way at the moment. But again, as I say, look, we're very positive people and we'll find a positive way through this.
Yeah, definitely. That's great. I love your positivity. And I know it's been funny kind of getting to see almost like the inside of everyone's house over the last couple of months. And do you have any tips for getting better on the video calls?
Well, I suppose you do need, I usually wear a tie and all the rest. You have no idea what I'm wearing down below. No, sorry. I'm wearing, yeah. By the way, you visit people, I'm wondering, well, I know what they're wearing. And I was curious to check what was behind me on the wall to make sure that it was something appropriate or something cultural or educational. So you watch that, you look at yourself in the screen and you see, oh, I don't want that there. And I have a map of Australia there, as I have in the office as well. But you become... I'm conscious, I've just put my hand across my mouth, said, stop doing that, you're on a small screen. And I suppose also the thing is, I'm sure you've discovered, the amount of people who speak either too fast or don't allow, you know, to realize that the sound isn't as great as it is and people haven't got the visual cues you normally have. Mm-hmm. So to slow down and talk more deliberately. And I have to say to myself, because I know I speak fast naturally. And of course, that's accentuated on these calls. So that's one thing, just speak slower, speak more directly to the camera. And critically, which is always good advice, don't speak too long.
Yeah, that's a good one. And so we can keep the UGG boots on, but just make sure they're out of sight.
Absolutely, be discreet, but be below screen level, that's fine.
Exactly. And so how is the Irish community in Australia responding to the pandemic?
I've been very impressed by the solidarity that's been shown both there in Sydney, but right across in all the major cities in Adelaide, Perth, Melbourne and Brisbane as well. And the Irish community have rallied behind in terms of support for particularly more vulnerable members, whether it was people through age or infirmity or indeed mental health issues. And Irish groups right across Australia have rallied behind the various support organisations. And I've been very impressed. And that's, again, it's a great thing about our community. It's one of the things that make me so proud to be Ambassador of Ireland. When I see that when you call, when the Lansdowne, whatever organisation it is, calls on support, we know we're going to get it. We're going to get it in buckets. And that's the greatest thing about our community. We have all these lovely expressions in Irish, you know, there's Scahi Céile, Warden Stadina, Corn na Gorsan. But then you realise when you call on people to stand up to the plate and to help and support, we do that. And that's one of the things that has been extraordinary right across for people who've, you know, live here permanently, the backpackers who are stuck at various points. In each case that we've turned to an organisation or a group or individuals for support, the embassy or the consulate general there in Sydney, we've got an unqualified support from members of the Irish community. And that's what impresses me most. And as I say, really instills my sense of pride in being Irish, that we do these things and we're doing it at the moment.
Yeah, it's been fantastic to see some of the initiatives that have been set up and just how supportive everyone has been, even in the business communities, and just really just seeing everyone kind of come together like that. So yeah, it's been really, really great. And what has the Irish government's response been to the Irish overseas?
Well, when this struck first back in March, April, particularly March here in Australia, we had a number of stranded people in a number of cities, I think at least four, if I can't remember them all now, probably five. We had to try and arrange emergency, you know, flights home for them. People were stuck, their flights had been cancelled. Some of them had run into trouble with finances. You know, this, they were paying for flights which were cancelled. They weren't getting recouped. And the government, through the embassy and the consulate and the honorary consulate in Perth, helped arrange flights for people. And then I suppose we said, okay, not everybody wants to fly home, and not everybody is, you know, a lot of the people we're talking about are resident here and live here, some are born here. So we got extra support from the government, from the Emigrant Support Program at the Department of Foreign Affairs. And we support the groups we already support, as I was saying, in Perth, Sydney, Melbourne and Brisbane. And we gave them extra support to be able to give, in some cases, emergency relief by way of food packages, others in by way of iPads, so people who were otherwise isolated on their own would have access, other than through the phone, that they could do, as we're doing, you know, VCs and the like, and got some training in that. And I think so. I think the government has been, and that's right across, there was emergency type evacuations from various parts of Latin America. Mainland Europe is not the same problem, and the UK is not the same problems. But from the Americas and other parts of Asia, the government helped support people. And I suppose the other big thing the government was doing during this, particularly in China, was getting extra supplies of the protective emergency clothing. That was a big thing as well, that my colleagues in the embassy in Beijing in particular were involved with. So the government and the Foreign Service, with the active support, again, I say, of the Irish communities right across the globe, in the case we're talking about now, in the usual way that we can and do. So the government has supported that and facilitated that, catalyzed mm-hmm. that, I suppose.
Yeah, that's great. And actually, my dad was actually here in March when everything was kind of kicking off, and he got a bit stranded here for a while, and he received great support from the embassy. So I got to kind of see firsthand then, you know, just how much was being done, and it was really helpful, which was great. And what's the government's position on those dual citizens that are unable to travel back to Australia?
Well, it's very difficult. I mean, we have very little. I have to just put it bluntly, there's very little we can do. We have been talking to the authorities here through networks like the European Union representation next door. We, as part of the European Union, try to support in any way we can people to get back to Australia. I mean, our main emphasis all along has been dual citizens and permanent residents who wanted to go to Ireland. And as you know, they were also blocked. And we had a very significant, a number of hundreds, and I've forgotten the figure now, over, you know, the last while that have been trying to get to Ireland. And I suppose that's, we've spent most of our energy. But equally, I recognise there's the Australian government estimate there's something like 30,000 Australians around the world that need to get back. And obviously wow. there's a number. So yeah, so it's a real problem, and it's one that, you know, we've still got some residual issues that people want to contact the embassy or consulate. We'll still do what we can to help people. I'm sorry to say, there is very little we can do to help people come from Australia. It's talked to the Australian embassy in Dublin, and I don't like to be passing it on, but that's the most effective way, I think, of doing that.
Yeah, that's great. And God, yeah, you've had your work cut out for you. And I guess there's been no manual for how to navigate this situation. So, you know, I can imagine you've been under a lot of pressure to kind of, you know, deal with the situation. So, yeah, that's been great. And on a lighter note, I live in Maroubra. And I've started taking up surfing during this pandemic. So the locals aren't too impressed because there's so many people that have just taken up surfing. They're like, get out of my way. So is there any hobbies that you have taken up, or have you, you know, gotten into anything weird and wonderful?
Well, every morning I go walking in nearby Stirling Park here. It's about 4 minutes out the gate of the house here, and it's just around the corner, and it is full of kangaroos. So every morning I go walking in the park with the kangaroos. Now, I wouldn't tell everybody this, but just because nobody else is listening to this.
It's just me and you.
Just me and you. I have a quick chat with the kangaroos, Australia. They have good passive knowledge of Ireland. They never answer me in any abrupt manner. So, no, to be serious, I love walking here. It's the park. Canberra is a very, as you know, it's called the bush capital. And we literally have an example of the bush down the street here, and it's lovely. And I suppose I'm trying to get back into reading more than I am, because so much of my job is reading. Reading is not a pastime. It's kind of like, that's what I do for my job. I prepare various notes. I read documents. That's my job. But I'm trying to read this myself, to saying, no, reading is the most enjoyable pursuit possible. So I'm getting back somewhat to reading, both prose, nonfiction.
Oh, that's lovely. I've actually been doing that myself as well. I've used the Goodreads app, which is great because you can set like a reading challenge for the year. Which is kind of cool. Now, I used to think that I would prefer to listen to anything except for more news about Brexit, but I've been proved wrong over the last couple of months. However, it is starting to come back into the news. So, you know, how are you seeing things at the moment?
Well, there's a European Council today. That's when the heads of government and some heads of state get together, and they discuss the major issues facing Europe. And of course, the major issue facing the European Union is Brexit, and no country less so than Ireland. I mean, obviously, we will be the country most impacted, even more indeed than the United Kingdom itself. So we have very, very deep concerns about that. And I suppose the great thing about, sorry, there's no great thing about Brexit. That sentence. No, reassuring thing that has happened during the process of Brexit is the solidarity we've seen from the other 26 member states of the European Union. When it came to the issue of a protocol for Ireland and Northern Ireland, particularly one which would protect the achievement of the Good Friday Agreement and the peace process and the bringing together of the economies of North and South, and the fact that, you know, commerce, trade across the border is so successful since particularly 1998, that has been the great thing. So that's all the good news and that's all the positive. I suppose the big challenges are facing the European Union, how to bring this forward. There's indications in the media, and I don't know how true these are, but you know, that the UK Prime Minister Boris Johnson is talking about walking away if there are certain things aren't met. There's issues around fisheries, which is very sensitive from an Irish point of view, and the French President Macron is talking about it being a deal breaker for the French. It's very important for Ireland. Fisheries are around the Irish coast and on the island of Ireland. And there's other issues. And we have been emphasizing, I suppose, Brexit for us is very important because so much of our exports have historically gone either to the UK or through the UK. So you would have concern. And sadly, the budget, the government budget that Minister Pascal Donoghue and Minister Michael McGrath launched yesterday, I think in the opening paragraph, the minister said, our budget is premised on there being a no-deal Brexit. And that's very sad. And that it would be very damaging, well, very damaging to the European Union right across the UK and, of course, Ireland. And that, so there, it's not positive at the moment. But look, we're Irish, so we don't wallow too much in the negative. We say, look, the possibility is there. If you think of, if I go back to the, you know, the Good Friday Agreement itself and the achievement of peace on the island of Ireland, at times it looked like that was very, very difficult. We achieved that and it's sustained. So our politics is the art of the possible. So let's just hope that, you know, some progress is made today or the next 2 days, and that it'll carry through, and that by the end of the year, when we need it really in the next couple of weeks, that we'll be able to achieve something that will be successful and deliver Brexit to the satisfaction of the UK and the satisfaction of the other, or the 27 members of the European Union.
Yeah, exactly. Some tough decisions ahead, but I guess we've been through tough times before and we need to stay positive. So I've got two rapid fire questions to finish you up. So they're very serious questions now. And the first one is drink of choice over this period. Have you any quarantini that you've been making?
No, I shouldn't be sticking with brand reputations, but I'm a Guinness drinker by choice. And that would be my favorite imbibement, and yep, it continued. So somebody did introduce me. I mentioned a halfway to St. Patrick's Day event. And with the chef that we use here in the embassy, came the drum powder gin sorbet. Oh, yeah. So that was something I've never experienced before. So a nice sorbet based on Leitrim gin. So I commend that to those who want to add a little.
Very good. And lastly, Tato or King?
As a kid, Tato were always King were always slightly more expensive, so a bit more cherchée than that, you know. But Tato I can buy in my local supermarket here in Canberra, in Coles, thanks to Taste of Ireland. So Tato is now my favourite.
Very good, very good. Well, thank you so much, Brendan. It was fantastic to talk to you this evening. And we're going to just check in if Philip has any questions from anyone. So Philip, let me know if there's any questions and then we'll wrap it up and go over to the music.
Thanks, Kate.
No, we're going to keep going here. We've taken up enough time of Brendan, so we'll thank you very much from everybody in the Lands End Club, Brendan. Thank you very much for giving us your time again this evening.
Thank you, Bill. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
See you now. Woohoo!
Nope.
All right. Now, before we, you're going to have to jump out of the, before we move on to, Hang on a second. Before we move on, we've had Karen Murphy has been texting us from the St. Patrick's Day committee, the festival committee. There is a big event coming on down here at the Rocks on Sunday, the 25th of October. It's Exploring the Rocks, and the markets are turning Irish from 10 o'clock in the morning till 5 o'clock in the evening. From 1 o'clock, there's going to be a roving piper and dancers. There's going to be Irish postbox time capsules. You can write yourself a postcard, which will be placed in the time capsules and opened in 20 years' time. The Art Festival, the Irish Consulate, and the Aisling Society with an exhibit of 20 Irish-Australian women who shaped Australia. And that'll all be happening on Sunday, the 25th of October. So please get on down to the Rocks Markets, the Turning Irish, for that day. What else do we have to cover before we go? Oh, yes, please, in addition to the questions that you sent through for the ambassador that we did not read out, to make up for that, we are going to read out and ask, what's your name again? Peter. I'm going to call him Neil. We're going to ask Peter to play the request that you send us through. So if you have a special request for somebody that you love or somebody that you're married to, please just send them through and we'll get Peter to play with them.
Yes.
All right. Does anybody want to hear anything more from me or do they just want to hear Peter singing? All right. I'm out of here. I'll be back later. See you in a bit. Enjoy.
Thanks, Philip. For coming, everybody. God bless. It's been wonderful. Thank you. I have another gig in March 2021. It's lovely. Lovely to be here. Hope everybody's well at home. Okay, as Philip said, I'm going to do a little bit of Neil. I'm the Irish-Australian impersonating the American, Jewish, Russian, Polish performer. So, that's a mouthful, isn't it, really? It is. It's a mouthful. So we'll do some Neil, we do some Irish, we do some stuff that I used to do in Kitty O'Shea's a million years ago. So if you got any requests at all, just send them in online and we'll see if we can do them. Somebody will read them out. Here's a Christie song. This is a good way of starting off, actually. Going there, everybody. You're very welcome to this evening's cabaret. I want to thank you for the trouble. Ah, you're out to take it to come and hear me play. I know the efforts that you make and all the trouble that you have to take when you decide you're going to go and see a show. The wife says, oh, not Christy Moore. I've seen him loads of times before. I'm going to miss Gay Byrne and the Late Late Show. Well, as people hear upon me words from every corner of the world, from Port Darlington, Port Leash and Tullamore, from 2 Mile House and Poolafuga, Black Trench, Cut Bush and Boolia, such a crowd I've never seen before. You're very welcome, welcome everyone, special branch you're on the one, Fine Gael, Fine Gael, Sinn Féin. When the elections are all over, we'll all be pushing up clover, and everyone in the graveyard rolls the same. Hip! My belly thought my tongue was cut, and all the restaurants were shut, as I was driving up through Kinnegad. So I drove up to Mother Hubbard's, where I saw a swarm of truckers, and I said to my place, this place doesn't look too bad. In came a 40-foot lorry, leaking lines of slurry, when the king of the road, he jumped down and he said to me, hey John, don't I know your face? Are you Paddy O'Reilly or Brendan Grace? Are you Mary Black or Freddie White? Is it? Oh. I tell you what happened to me today. I was coming up the dual carriageway. Half the Marathon, the Irish Army, they were all over the place. So I rolled in and I pulled my window down. The siduri surrounded me car. I thought it was the Third World War. Some of them boys were throwing Shiite chips. I said, hey, Brigadier General, what appears to be the trouble? He said, don't forget your shovel. Have you any old autographs or tapes? On, the words are easy. You're very welcome to this evening's cabaret, because that's what it's all about, having a bit of fun, having a bit of crack, having a sing-song and several pints of Guinness. So I know Philip said he liked this song the other day, so I'll give it a lash now. One of the first Christie songs I ever learned a million years ago. If you know the words of it, don't bother singing it. I'll do it on my own.
Seen standing 16, 1 and 2, the eyes wild and green. You ride the horse so well, hands light to the touch, I could never go with you, no matter how I wanted to. Right on, see you. I could never go with you, no matter how I wanted to. When you ride into the night, without a trace behind, you run your claw along my gut one last time. It turns a face, empty space we used to lie. Look for the spark that lights the night through the teardrops in the eyes. Right on, see you. I could never go with you, no matter how I wanted to. Right on, see you. I could never go with you, no matter how I wanted to.
Done. Super song.
Keep the requests coming. There's thousands of them.
All right. All right. A little bit of Neil. Here we go.
Jeans. And honey, sweet.
this. No hands, no touching hands, okay, none of that.
Where it began, I can't begin to know it, but then I know it's growing strong. Was in the spring, Jesus, the spring became the summer. Who'd have believed you'd come along? Touching hand, please don't touch my hand. Reaching out, touching, no, don't touch me. Touching you, sing it, you know it now. Oh, sweet Caroline, your time never seems so good, so good. Don't seem so lonely. We fill it up with only two. And when I hurt, it runs off my shoulders. How can I hurt when I'm here with you?
Here we go, hands up now.
Oh. Touch it warm, reaching out, touching me, touching you. Come on now. Oh, sweet Caroline, your time never seems so good, so good.
Way of getting the alcohol all the way through your body. Are we? Huh? Crunch? Oh, good lord! we got a true Neil Diamond fan here. Crunchy granola. From Hot August Night, 1972. Good choice.
down. Down, deep, deep, deep down. I got a song been on my mind. And the tune kept the sound of the words all rhyme. Diddly-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-doo. And don't say much and it won't affect. Sing it at school, the libelous at your home. Never knowing what you're growing, and you're showing your own team. Good luck! Let me hear that, get me near that, crunchy granola sweets.
Tearjerkers, but we'll do. You know who it's for? Is it request? Let's say, no, not for anybody. Just okay. Nice song written by the Furies. Jean Farrell, Judy Farrell.
Tears have all been shed now. We've said our last goodbyes. His soul's been blessed, now he's laid to rest. And it's now I feel alone. He was more than just my father, a teacher, my best friend. He can still be heard in the tunes we shared when I played them on my own. And I never will forget him, 'cause he made me what I am. Though he may be gone, his memory lingers on. And I miss him, my old man. As a boy, he'd take me walking through mountains, fields, and streams. Then he'd showed me things not known to kings, a secret between him and me, like the colors on the pheasant as it rises in the dawn, how to fish or make a wish beside a fairy tree. And I never will forget him, 'cause he made me what I am. Though he may be gone, his memory lingers on, and I miss him, my old man. And I never will forget him, 'cause he made me what I am. Though he may be gone, his memory lingers on, and I miss him, my own man. Nice song. Bit of Finbar. A bit of Finbar, yeah.
Oh, thank you very much. Oh, yeah.
Take me away from the city, lead me to where I can be on my own. Wanted to see you, but now that I have, I just wanna be left alone. Always remember your kind words, I still remember your name. I see you tossing and turning, now the things just won't be the same. I remember that summer in Dublin, when the Lafayette stank like hell, and the young people walking down Grafton Street, everyone was looking so well. I was singing a song I heard somewhere called Rock and Roll Never Forgets, when my humming was smothered by a 46A and the scream of a low flying jet. You got it. So I jumped on a bus to Dunleary, stumbling off to pick up my guitar, when a drunk on the bus told me how to get rich. I was glad we went going too far. So I'm leaving on Wednesday morning, I'm trying to find the place I can't hear. Wind of the birds, the sea and the rocks, and my open roads always are near. And sometimes I tire of the quiet, and I wanna walk back up that hill. I just get on the road and I stick out my thumb, for I know for sure you'll be there still. I remember that summer in Dublin, when the Lafayette stank like hell, and the young people walking down Grafton Street, everyone was looking so well. I was singing a song I heard somewhere called Rock and Roll Never Forgets, when my heart was smothered by a 46A and the scream of a low-flying jet. I jumped on a bus to Dunleary, I'm stopping up to pick up my guitar, when a drunk on the bus told me how to get rich. I was glad we went going too far. One more time. Sing it. I remember that summer in Dublin, when the
the lithias are stacked like hell, and the young people walking down Grafton Street, everyone was looking so well. I was singing a song I hear somewhere called Rock and Roll Never Forgets. When my humming, it was smothered by a 46A and the scream of a low flying jet. So I jumped on a bus to Dunleary. I'm stopping up to pick up my guitar. When a drunk on the bus told me how to get rich, I was glad we weren't going too far. Ooh, I was glad we weren't going too far. Summer in Ballyclea. Bagatelle, Jesus, I'm telling you. Oh. I took a stroll on the old long walk on the day I met a little girl. We stopped to talk on the grand soft day. I asked you, friend, what's a fella to do? 'Cause her hair was black and her eyes were blue. Then I'd be taking a twirl around the solitude prom with a Galway girl. Come on, clap your hands. We were halfway there when the rain came singing day I, and she asked me up to a flat downtown on a grand soft day I. If her hair was black and her eyes were blue, so I took her hand and then I gave her a twirl. And then I lost my heart to a Galway girl. I was all alone. Sing! With a broken heart and a ticket home, grand soft day I am. And I ask you, friend, tell me what would you do if her hair was black and her eyes were blue? See, I traveled around, been all over the world. Boys, I never seen nothing like a Galway girl. Clap your hands, come on! I used to love once a long, long time ago. Oh, I'll do it next week. Good songs, aren't they? Good songs.
Ring a ring, rose in. As the light declines, I remember Dublin City in the rare old times. Praise and songs and stories, heroes of renown, the past and tales and glories that once was Dublin town. Hallowed halls and houses, the haunting children's rhymes, once was part of Dublin in the rare old times.
Come on, everybody sing at home as well.
Ring a ring a Rosie, as the light declines, I remember in the rare old times. Oh, me name, it is Sean Dempsey. I'm as Dublin as can be. Born hard and late in Pimlico, in a house that ceased to be. By trade I was a cooper, lost out to redundancy. Like me house that fell to progress, I'm a trace, a memory. I courted Peggy Dignan, she was as pretty as you please. She's a rogue, a child of Mary, from the rebel liberties. And I lost her to a student chap, with skin that was as black as coal, when he took her off to Birmingham. Ah, he took away my soul.
Everybody in the dust house, come on.
Ring a ring.
Beautiful.
As the light declines, I remember.
Jesus, you swear we've been drinking.
Oh, the years have made me bitter, and the cargoes dim me brain, cause Dublin keeps on changing. Ah, when nothing seems the same, and the Pillar and the Met have gone, and the Royals long since pulled down, as the great unyielding concrete makes a city of my town.
Here we go.
Ring a ring of Rosie, as the light declines, I remember Dublin city in the rare old times.
15 verses to go.
Oh, the years have made me bitter, and the gargoyles dim me brain, cause Dublin keeps on changing. Ah, when nothing seems the same, should the Pillar and the Met have gone, and the Royals long since pulled down, as a great unyielding concrete, it makes a city of my town. Ring a ring a Rosie,
come on.
As the light declines, I remember Dublin city in the rare old times.
One more for the road, loud and clear.
Ring a ring a Rosie, as the light declines, I remember Dublin city in the rare old times.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Oh, God. I mentioned earlier on that I used to sing in Kitty O'Shea's a million years ago when I was younger. To do a series of songs like this that everybody used to love. They're not necessarily Irish songs, but just sing-along songs. So if you know the words, sing along.
On a warm summer's evening, on a train bound for nowhere, met up with a gambler, we were both too tired to sleep. We turned to stare, the window at the darkness. Boredom overtook him. He began to speak. He said, "Son, I made a lot out of reading people's faces, knowing what the cards were by the way they held their eyes. And if you don't mind me saying, I can see your eyes and faces. For a taste of the whiskey, I'll give you some advice." So I handed him my bottle, and he drank down my last swallow. Then he bummed a cigarette, and he asked me for a light. And the night got deadly quiet, and his face lost all expression. Said, "If you're gonna play the game, boy, you got to learn.
Everybody sing!
You got to know when to hold.
All right.
Know when to fold up. Know when to walk away. Know when to run. You never count your money. When you're sitting at the table, there'll be time enough for counting when the dealing's done. Every gambler knows that the secret to survival is knowing what to throw away and knowing what to keep. And every hand's a winner, oh, and every hand's a loser. And the best that you can hope for is to die in your sleep." And when he finished speaking, he turned back towards the window, pressed out a cigarette, and faded off to sleep. Somewhere in the darkness, you know the gambler, he broke in. And in his final words, "I found days I could keep." Go! You got to know when to hold.
Sing it now.
Know when to fold up. Know when to walk away. Know when to run. You never count your money. When you're sitting at the table, there'll be time enough to count.
Clap your hands, everybody. Clap it out.
You got to know when to hold.
When to hold.
Know when to fold up. Know when to walk away.
Come on.
You never count your money. When you're sitting at, there'll be.
All right now.
When the deed is done, you got to know when to hold.
Come on.
Know when to fold up. Know when to walk away. Know when to run. You never count your money. When you're sitting at the table, there'll be time enough to count it. When the deal is done. Almost 7. West Virginia. Blue Ridge Mountain. Shenandoah River. Life is older, older than the trees, younger than the mountain, blowing like the breeze. Grand Zero, take me home, on to the place.
Do it!
West Virginia, mountain mama, take me home. My memories gathered round her, miner's lady, streaming to blue water. Dark and dusty, faded on the sky. There's a misty taste of moonshine and a teardrop in my eye. Country road, take me home to the place where I belong. Take me home, country road.
One more time.
Hey, country road, take me home to the place where I belong.
Any more requests coming in from the nobody else? Oh, be Jesus, it is if you're walking. Oh. For sure this room and we work hard for the crack. Getting up late on Sundays, I never get to mass. It's a long, long way from Clare to here. It's a long, long way from Clare to here. Oh, it's a long, long way, it gets further day by day. It's a long, long way from Clare to here. When Friday night comes around and he's only into fighting, me ma won't write a letter home, cause I'm too tired for writing. It's a long, long way from Clare to here. It's a long, long way from Clare to here. Oh, it's a long, long way, it's further day by day. It's a long, long way from Clare to here. I feel I hear a piper playing, maybe it's an ocean. And I feel I hear white horses on the little ocean. It's a long, long way from Clare to here. It's a long, long way from Clare to here. Oh, it's a long, long way, it's further day by day. It's a long, long way from Clare to here. Oh, it's a long, long way, it's further day by day. It's a long, long way from Clare to here. It's a long way from Clare to here. It's a long, long way from Clare to way from Clare to here. Thank you very much. Let me know any more you can think of. Otherwise, I'll keep throwing them at you and do another Christie one if I like. Black is the color of my true love's hair. Lips are like some roses fair. She's got the sweetest smile and the gentlest hands. And I love the ground whereon she stands. I love my love. Ah, well, she knows, cause I love the ground whereon she goes. I wish that the day soon would come when she and I would be as one. Black is the color of my true love's hair. And her lips are like some rose's fair. She's got the sweetest smile and the gentlest hands. Ah, when I love the ground whereon she stands. I go to the client and I mourn and weep.
for satisfied. I never can be. Then I'd write her a letter, just a few short lines, and I'd suffer death 1,000 times. Oh, black is the color of my true love's hair, and her lips are like some roses fair. She's got the sweetest smile and the gentlest hands, and I love the ground whereon she stands. Yes, I love the ground whereon she stands. I love the ground.
It's a good song, isn't it? It's a cracker. I don't know whether this is appropriately correct or not to do this song. I'll give it a lash. When I went home on a Monday night, as drunk could be, I saw a horse outside the door where my old horse should be. And I called the wife and I said to her, would you kindly tell to me who owns that horse outside the door where my should be. Ah, you're drunk, you silly old fool, and still you cannot see. Sure, that's the lovely sound that people are said to be. It's many a day to travel 100 miles or more, but a saddle on a sound, sure, I've never seen before. And when I went home on a Tuesday night, as drunk could be, I saw a coat behind the door where my old coat should be. And I called the wife and I said to her, would you kindly tell to me who owns that coat behind the door where my old coat should be? Ah, you're drunk, you silly old fool, still you cannot see. That's the lovely blanket that me mother sent to me. It's many a day I traveled 100 miles or more, but buttons on a blanket sure I've never seen before. Up you boy. When I went home on a Wednesday night, as drunk could be, I saw a pipe upon the chair where my old pipe should be. And I called the wife and I said to her, come here, would you kindly tell to me who owns that pipe upon the chair where my old pipe should be? Ah, you're drunk, you silly old fool, and still you cannot see. That's the lovely tin whistle that me mother sent to me. It's many a days I traveled 100 miles or more, with tobacco in a tin whistle, sure I'd never seen before. And when I went home on a Thursday night, as drunk could be, I saw two boots beneath the bed where my old boots should be. And I called the wife and I said to her, come here, would you kindly tell to me who owns the boots beneath the bed where my old boots should be? You're drunk, you silly old fool, still you cannot see. Sure, dear, two lovely flower pots me mother sent to me. It's many a days I traveled 100 miles or more, with laces on flower pots I've never seen before. Now when I'm at home on a Friday night, as drunk could be, I saw a head upon the bed where my old head should be. And I called the wife and I said to her, would you kindly tell to me who owns that head upon the bed where my old head should be? Ah, you're drunk, you silly old fool, still you cannot see. Sure, that's the baby boy that me mother sent to me. Well, it's many a days I traveled 100 miles or more, with whiskers on that baby, sure I've never seen before.
And when I went home on a Saturday night, transmogrified, as drunk and drunk could be, I saw two hands upon you, where my old hands should be. And I called the wife when I said to her, will you kindly tell to me, who owns them hands upon you, where my old hands should be? Ah, you're drunk, you silly old fool, and still you cannot see. Sure, that's the lovely nightgown that me mother sent to me. It's many a days I travel, 100 miles or more, with fingers in a nightgown, sure I've never seen before.
Sad verse.
When I went home on a Sunday night, as drunk could be. I can't do this, can I? Turn your cameras off. I saw a thing and called your king where my old king should be. And I called me wife and I said to her, come here, would you kindly tell to me who owns that thing inside your king where my old king should be? Ah, you're drunk, you see, you're fooling still, you cannot see. Yeah, that's the lovely rolling pin before it's sent to me. It's many a days I travel, 100 miles or more. Whiskers on a rolling pin, I've never seen before.
Oh, Jesus. All right, we haven't drunk any of this tonight.
Red, red wine goes to my head. It makes me forget that I still need a soul. Red, red wine, does it talk to you? And all I can do, I've done. Those memories won't go. No memories won't go. I swore that with time, thoughts of you would leave my head. I was wrong, but now I find just one thing makes me forget.
Sing it, everybody.
Red, red wine. Stay close to me. And don't let me be alone. It's tearing apart.
Was that a bit of reggae music? Worldwide number one hit. Sing it, reggae style.
Red, red wine goes to my head. It makes me forget that I still need her so warm. Red, red wine, it's up to you. And all I can do, I've done. You know those memories won't go home. No memories won't go.
You're getting it, I can feel it.
I just want that quick time. Thoughts of you leave my head. Was wrong. Now I find just one thing makes me forget.
Sing it, people.
Red, red wine. Yeah. Stay close to me. stone is tearing apart. My blue in the house, clap your hands, everybody in the house. Come on. Dutch house, clap your hands, everybody in the house. Everybody in the house, say, oh. Everybody in the house, say, woo. Said red, red wine make me feel so fine. I hear it on the radio all of the time. Everybody get to have some fun. UB40, we be number one. Red, red wine, come on. Stay close to me. Don't let me be alone. He's tearing the plum up. Mom, one more time. In the house, clap your hands, everybody in the house. Come on. In the house, clap your hands, everybody in the house. Everybody in the house, say, oh. Hey. Everybody in the house, say, woo. I said, red, red wine make me feel so fine. Keeps me fucking all of the time. Everybody get to have some fun. UB40, we be number one. Red, red wine, last time. Stay close to me. Don't let me be alone. It's tearing my blue, blue heart. Here's the one he wrote for the Monkees. Disappointment haunted all of my dreams. Oh, then I saw her face. Now I'm a believer. Not a trace. I'm down in my mind. Cause I'm in love. I'm a believer. I can't believe her if I try. More or less, give a thing. Seems the more I gave, you know, the less I got. What's the use of trying when all you get is pain? When I needed sunshine, I got rain. Then I saw her face. Now I'm a believer. Not a trace. I'm down in my mind. Cause I'm in love.
I'm in love.
I'm a believer. I can't leave her. If I try one more time. No, not if I try. Saw her face. Now I'm a believer. Not a trace. A doubt in my mind. Cause I'm in love.
I'm a believer.
I can't believe her. If I try one more time. Then I saw her face. Now I don't believe her, not a trace.
Stop it, you spoil me. I don't know if you'll know this one or not. You want to keep going? Do you want to keep going for a bit? You've run out of internet. That's grand, that's grand. Last time I sang this song was, Jesus, probably 6-7 months ago. I wonder why. I don't know if you can see the changes that have come over me. These past few days I've been afraid that I might drift away. I'm telling the stories, singing songs, make me think about where I come from. That's the reason why I seem so far away today. Let me tell you that I love you, that I think about you all the time. Caledonia, you're calling me, now you're going home. But if I should become a stranger, it would make me more than sad. Caledonia is everything I've ever had. Oh, I have moved and kept on moving, proved a point, no conclusion. Lost the friends that I needed losing, found others on the way. I've kissed the girls and I've left them crying. Stolen dreams, there's no denying. Traveled hard, sometimes conscious flight, somewhere in the way. Let me tell you that I love you, that I think about you all the time. Caledonia, you're calling me, now you're going home. And if I shall become a stranger, you know it would make me more than sad. Caledonia is everything I've ever had. I'm sitting here before the fire, an empty room, the farmer's choir. The flames of coal don't get any higher, they're withered now, they're gone. I'm steady thinking that my way is clear, and I know what I will do tomorrow. When hands have shaken and kisses flowed, then I will disappear. Let me tell you that I love you, that I think about you all the time. Caledonia, you're calling me, now you're going home. And if I shall become a stranger, it would make me more than sad. Caledonia is everything I've ever had.
One more time.
Oh, and let me tell you that I love you, that I think about you all the time. Caledonia, you're calling, now you're going home. And if I shall become a stranger, you know it would make me more than sad. Caledonia is everything I've ever had.
Caledonia is everything I've ever had.
That is a nice song. It is a nice song. We'll bring the mood up a little bit.
Just bring the mood up a little.
Driving keg. As I sat looking up at the Guinness side, I could never figure out how your back stayed up with the fort part after fort.
Sing it again!
Oh, goodbye to the port and to the vodka and the stag, to the sweet dick and the harpy, the bottle driving keg. As I sat looking up at the Guinness side, I could never figure out how your back stayed up with the fort part after 14 years of stews. Hey! Well, I dreamt a dream the other night, I couldn't sleep a wink. The rats were trying to count the sheep, and I was off to drink. There were footsteps in the parlour, and there were voices in the stairs, and I was climbing up the walls, Jesus, I was moving around the chairs. Then I looked up from under the blanket, up at the fireplace, the Pope and John F. Kennedy, Jesus, they were staring me in the face. So suddenly it dawned on me I was getting the old DTs. When the child of Prague began to dance around the mantelpiece. Oh, goodbye to the port and bat, to the vodka and the stag, to the spit dick and the harpy, the bottle driving keg. As I sat looking up at the Guinness and I could never figure it. The young man stayed up in the store right after 14 weeks of stew. Hey! Well, I swore upon the Bible I'd never touch a drop. My heart was palpitating, I'm sure it was going to stop. And thinking I was dying, I gave my soul to God to keep, and a tenor to St. Anthony to help me get some sleep. Well, I fell into an awful nightmare, and I got a dreadful shock, when I dreamt there was no duty free up at the airport up at Knock. I dreamt in Paisley was saying the rosary, and Mother Teresa was on the pill. Frank Patterson was out of his bed, and he was singing Spatzel Hill. Oh, goodbye to the pub, and to the vodka and the stag, to the spit dick and the harpy, the bottle dropping keg. As I sat looking up at the Guinness side, I could never figure out how your man stayed up in the sun, or after 40 pints of stews. Oh, goodbye to the pub, and to the vodka and the stag, to the spit dick and the harpy, the bottle dropping keg. As I sat looking up at the Guinness side, I could never figure out how your man stayed up in the sun, or after 40 pints of stews.
Fourteen pints of sauce. Jesus. Any more requests? Have you any requests of me? Keep going. How about the Green Fields of France? No? Okay, no, not the Green. Fairy Tale of New York? No? Okay, all right. I used to love her. I have fallen for another, she can make her own way home. And even if she asked me now, I'd let her go alone. I used to see her up the chapel when she went to Sunday Mass. And when she'd go to receive, I'd kneel down there and watch her pass. Glory of her ass. Oh, I used to love her, I used to love her once. A long, long time ago, I used to love her, I used to love her once. A long, long time ago, gone. All my loving is gone. Oh, gone. All my loving is gone. You remember her collecting the concern and the busy. She was on the fourth day, our passing. Water and black tea. I walked upright and made a conscientious contribution.
And I winked at her to tell her I'd seduce her in the future when she's feeling loser. Oh, I used to love her, I used to love her once. A long, long time ago, I used to love her, I used to love her once. A long, long time ago, gone. All my loving is gone. Oh, gone. All my loving is gone. So now you know the truth of it, she's no longer my obsession. Though the thoughts and dreams I've had of her will take 6 months in confession. You see, I met this young one Thursday night, and she didn't take free expression. And her mission is to rid the world of this sinful depression. Jesus, we had a session. Oh, I used to love her, I used to love her once. A long, long time ago, I used to love her, I used to love her once. A long, long time ago, gone. All my loving is gone. Oh, gone. All my loving is gone. Oh, gone. Gone, gone, gone. Oh, gone. Gone, gone, gone. I have fallen for another, if she can make her own way home.
Oh my God, I haven't sung that in a million years.
Flies were swarming and dogs howling at the moon. With rosary beads and sandwiches for Stuttgart we began. Trucks are packed to German Fraserbrook and jump leads for the van. Some of the lads had never been away from home before. It was the first time Wacker set his foot outside of Inchicore. Before we left for Europe, we knew we need a plan. So we all agreed that Choxer was the man to drive the van. In Germany, the Autobahn was like the long mile road. There was every make and caravan, all carrying the full load. For transit and hiatus and an old Bedford from Chile. With engine overhearing from long haul and duty free. There were fans from Ballyfermot, Ballybock and Ballymun. And the journey of a lifetime, and the crack was 91. Choxer met a German's daughter on the banks of the River Rhine, and he told her she'd be welcome at Ballyferm at any time. As soon as we found Stuttgart, we got the wagons in a ring. Sean O'Gara the banjo, Peter played the mandolin. There were fans there from everywhere, attracted by the crowds, and the first flock told in Europe when Choxer passed the flagon round. But the session had ended when we finished all the stouts. The air mattresses inflated and the sleeping bags rolled out. And one by one we fell asleep. Choxer had a dream. He dragged himself and Jack Trouton sat down to pick the team. Up your boy, yeah. Choxer dreamt they poured the greed on Packy Bonner straight away. And that Moran, Whelan and McGrath were certainly to play. But tempers they began to rise, patience wearing thin. Jack wanted Cascarino, but Choxer wanted Quinn. The dream turned into a night, Sir Choxer stuck the head in Jack, who wanted to bring Johnny Giles and Eamon Dunphy back. The cock crew in the morning, it crew both loud and shrill. Choxer woke up in his sleeping bag many miles from Arbor Hill. The next morning, none of the experts gave us the slightest chance. They said the English team would lead us on a merry dance. With them Union Jacks, them English fans, for victory they were set. Until Ray Houghton got the ball and he stuck it in the net. What happened next was history, brought tears to many eyes. The day will be the highlight
of many people's lives. Jocks had climbed right over the top, and the last time he was seen was an arm with Jack Charles and singing Revenge for Skibbereen. Now Wanker's back in Inchicore, he's living with his mom. Jack Charlton has been proclaimed an honorary Irishman. Do you remember the German's daughter on the banks of the River Ryan? Didn't she show up at Ballyfermot? When first I saw that love light in your eyes, I thought the world held not but joy for me. And even though we've drifted far apart, I've never dreamed but what I dream of thee. I love you as I've never loved before. Since first I saw you on the village green, come to me ere my dreams of love are all. And I love you as I've loved you when you were sweet, when were sweet 16. When first I saw the love light in your eyes, I thought the world held not but joy for me. And even though we've drifted far apart, oh, I never dreamed but what I dreamed of thee.
Come on, you know it.
I love you as I've never loved before. Since first I saw you on the village green, come to me ere my dreams of love are all. And I love you as I've loved you when you were sweet, when sweet 16.
One for the road.
Yes, I love you as I've never loved before. Since first I saw you on village green, come to me ere my dreams of love are all. Sure, I love you as I loved you when you were sweet, when you were sweet 16.
Nice
Nice little song. Nice little song. Thank you.
I've been a wild rover for many a year, and I've spent all me money, and now I'm returning with gold and grey store. Sure, I never will play the wild rover no more, and it's no, nay, never, no, nay, never, no more will I play the wild rover, no, never, no more. I went to an alehouse I used to frequent, Doss House, and I told the landlady me money was spent. Care of no money. I asked her for credit, she answered me nay. Sure, a custom like yours I can have any day, and it's no, nay, never, no, nay, never, no more will I play the wild rover, no, never, no more. I took from me pocket 10 sovereigns bright, and the landlady's eyes opened wide with delight. And she said, I have whiskey, yeah, and wine's of the best, and the words that I spoke, they were only in jest. And it's no, nay, never, hop! No, nay, never, no more will I play the wild rover, no, never, no more. Irene, good night, Irene, Irene, good night, good night, Irene, good night, Irene, I see you in my dreams. Her eyes, they shone like diamonds, you'd think she's the queen of the land, with her hair hung over her shoulder, tied up with a black velvet band. In a neat little town called Belfast, apprentice to trade I was bound, and many's an hour of sweet happiness I spent in this neat little town, till a sad misfortune came o'er me that caused me to stray from the land, far away from my friends and relations, to follow the black velvet band. Come on, sing it. Well, her eyes, they shone like diamonds, you'd think she's the queen of the land, with her hair hung over her shoulder, tied up with a black velvet band. Dublin's fair city, where the girls are so pretty, I first set my eyes on sweet Molly Malone. And she wheels her wheelbarrow through streets broad and narrow, crying cockles, alive, alive, oh, sing it, alive, alive, oh, cockles and mussels, alive, alive, oh. She was a fishmonger, and sure 'twas no wonder, and so were her father and mother before. Now they each wheeled the barrow through streets broad and narrow, crying cockles and mussels, alive, alive, oh, sing, alive, alive, oh, alive, alive, oh, crying cockles and mussels, alive.
more time.
Alive, alive, oh, alive, alive, oh, crying cockles and mussels, alive.
Nancy Spain, Ordinary Man, Raglan Road.
Nancy. Nancy Spain. Nancy Spain, okay, all right, okay. I haven't sung in a while, but we...
You what?
Of all the stars that ever shone, nothing one has twinkled like your pale blue eyes. Like the golden corn at harvest time, your hair sailing in me boat, the wind gently it blows and fills me sail. Your sweet scented breath is everywhere. Daylight passing through the curtains of the passing nighttime is your smile. Oh, the sun in the sky is like your laugh. Come back to me, my Nancy, and linger for just a little while. Since you've left these shores, I know no peace of mind. No matter where I wandered, I'm still haunted by your name. Oh, the portrait of your beauty stays the same. Standing by the ocean, wondering where you've gone, will you return again? Oh, where is the ring I gave to Nancy Spain? On a day in spring, when the snow starts to melt and the streams to flow, the birds, I'll sing you a song. In a while I'll wander down by Bluebell Grove, where wildflowers grow, and I hope my lovely Nancy will return. And no matter where I wander, I'm still haunted by your name. The portrait of your beauty stays the same. Standing by the ocean, wondering where gone, will you return again? Oh, where is the ring I gave and Nancy Spain?
Let's sing it one more time.
Oh, no matter where I wandered, I'm still haunted by your name. Oh, the portrait of your beauty stays the same. Standing by the ocean, wondering where you've gone, will you return again? Oh, where is the ring I gave to Nancy Spain? Oh, where is the ring I gave to Nancy Spain?
That's a nice song. That's a nice, nice song. A nice song. Thank you very much. We've got. I'll do a couple more. I've been singing for 7 hours now. The daylight's coming out. It's a back bathroom break coming up. Okay, right. How about this one? You know this one.
Oh, last night as I lay dreaming of pleasant days gone by, my mind been bent on rambling to Ireland, I did fly. I stepped on board a vision and I followed with the wind. Oh, next I came to anchor at the cross near Spencer Hill. Been on the 23rd of June, the day before the fair, when Ireland's sons and daughters and friends assembled there. The young, the old, the brave and the bold, their duties to fulfill. At a parish church near Clooney, many miles from Spencer Hill. Well, I went to see me neighbour, just to see what they might say. Well, the old ones were all dead and gone, the young ones turning grey. Well, I met with Taylor Quigley, he's as bound as ever still. Well, he used to mend me breeches when I lived in Spencer Hill. Well, I paid a flying visit to my one and only love. She's as white as Annie Lily and as gentle as a dove. When she threw her arms around me, said, "Johnny, I love you still." Oh, she's yet the farmer's daughter and the pride of Spencer Hill. Well, I dreamt and I kneeled and kissed her as in days of yore. Oh, Johnny, you're only joking, as many's a time before. Well, the cock it crew in the morning, it crew both loud and shrill. When I walk in California, many miles from Spencer Hill. From the top, everybody sing. Oh, last night as I lay dreaming of pleasant days gone by, my mind been bent on rambling to Ireland, I did fly. Well, I stepped on board a vision and followed with the wind. Oh, next I came to anchor out across this spot.
Spencer Hill. Oh God, there's another song here. No, I need audience participation for this one, because you have to be my choir. That's what you haven't been all along. A hungry feeling came on stealing, and the mice were squealing in my prison cell. Everybody sing. And the old triangle went jingle jangle all along the banks of the Royal Canal. Oh, to begin the morning
this crew was ballin'. Get up your bouncy and clean up your sound in the old triangle. When jingle jangle all along the banks of the Royal Canal, for the screw was peeping and the lag was sleeping as he lay weeping for his girdle sound and the old triangle. When jingle jangle all along the banks of the Royal Canal, all the wind was sighing and the day was dying as the lag lay crying in his prison cell, and the old triangle. When jingle jangle all along the banks of the Royal Canal, up in a female prison there were 75 women, and among them sure I wish I did dwell in the old triangle. When jingle jangle all along the banks of the Royal Canal, all along the banks of the Royal Canal.
Guys, you've been absolutely, thanks so much to the Lansdowne Club, thanks so much to Philip O'Sullivan, everybody in the committee. Thank you so much for having me along here. Thank you to Kira and everybody here at the Doss House for having me. It's been a privilege and a pleasure, and hopefully with a bit of luck, we'll see you at the St. Patrick's Day luncheon next March. With a bit of luck. All right, please God, here we go. Clap your hands, come on.
On the 4th of July, 1806, we set sail from the sweet old Cork. We were sailing away with a cargo of bricks for the Grand City Hall of New York. 'Twas a wonderful craft, she was rigged for that, and oh how the wild wind drove her. She was several glass, she had 27 masts, and they called her the Irish Drover. We had 1 million bags of our best Sligo rags, we had 2 million barrels of gold, we had 3 million sides of a blind horse's hides, we had 4 million barrels of bone, we had 5 million hogs, 6 million dogs, 7 million barrels of porter, we had 8 million bales of a nanny goat's tails, and the hold of the Irish Drover. There was Barney McGee from the banks of the Lee, and there was Hogan from County Tyrone. There was Johnny McGurk, who was far stiffer work, and the chap from Westmead, Paul Malone. There was Slugger O'Toole, who was drunk as a rule, and fighting Dick Tracy from Dover. And your man, Dick McCann, from the banks of the band, was the skipper of the Irish Drover. Oh, no, Mickey Coote, who played hard on the flute, while the ladies lined up for a set. He would tootle and trill for his sparkling white drill, while the dancers were fluted and bet. With his smart, witty talk, he was cocked on the walk, as he rolled the dames under and over. When he took up a stance, they all knew at a glance that he sailed on the Irish Rover. Now he
say, 7 years when the measles broke out and our ship lost its way in the fog. Then the whale of a crew was reduced down to two, just myself and the captain's own dog. Then the ship took a rock, oh Lord, what a shock. Ho, ho, it was turned right over. It turned 9 times around, and the poor old dog was drowned. I'm the last of the Irish bowmen. How's your old work, people?
What about him? What about him? Played for 17 hours. Thank you very much. Thank you very much to the board. Thank you very much to Kira and the Doss House. Thank you very much for everybody tuning in. See us all again next whatever time, and we'll be back with the late, late Land Show.
Bye-bye. Sláinte.